The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, Unu Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Welcome to Pod Talk. I'm Paul Daniels.
I'm Jim Bell.
I swear to God, I just fucking totally brain farted.
Wow.
You must be fucking contagious, Jimmy.
Yeah, I know. Memory is contagious.
Where do you want to start?
I got four subjects. China, Trump. Brooklyn Bridge in Seattle.
Why don't we start with the Brooklyn Bridge?
The girl hit him on the cane. I thought it was a girl, and they said they were looking for a guy.
I seen the footage once, and it was so grainy and stuff.
They were highlighting it.
Right, okay. But I thought it was a two-by-four.
No, that's what I thought when you told me that. You said you've seen that.
Yeah.
Then when they showed it again, like I said, you could see the hand of the cane when she was behind her head.
Well, they got her.
She's in big trouble.
Salt battery with a dangerous weapon on a police officer. They don't take kindly to that.
Yeah, but you know what the DA would say? Call up the DA and say he's out on bail. Yeah, I wonder who paid that.
Well, there is that.
They just gave it no bail.
What's the incentive for her to show up to court?
They just destroyed an industry. Exactly. See, we don't have bail bondsmen in New Hampshire.
We don't have bail bondsmen in Mass either.
They just have a guy that comes from the court system. He's on 24 hours.
That's what they do in Mass.
Yeah, the bondsmen.
Yeah, but it's a state. It's not a private company. You got to pay.
Right, that's what I'm saying. They have a different name for it, but it's basically the same thing.
No, they said bail bondsman. Bail commissioner. That's who runs it.
No, it's not the bail bondsman. You ever seen a bail bondsman company here?
Why would anyone show back up to court anyways? Because if you get arrested, it's no different, and they're just going to let you go again. Come back for the next court hearing, you're right there. You know what I mean? That's ridiculous. I'm wondering what Trump's got for next week. I don't know, he's going to do something about this violence.
Something's got to be done. I don't understand why they can't throw the mayor out for dereliction of duty. They should be able to.
You know what I mean? The governor, if he had any balls.
Well, he's got the right to get rid of him.
But he ain't going to do it because they're blow buddies.
They slurp each other.
Oh, and related story. New York City's A police budget got slashed $1 billion. So they had to get rid of the crime task force and a couple other things. Domestic violence task force.
Gang test or something. Yeah, I believe that's the three.
The domestic violence one, gang, and crime task force, whatever. Anyways, Mayor de Blasio now has put eight cops on duty At the Black Lives Matter mural down in front of Trump Towers. A sergeant and seven officers, 20 rotating, 24 hours a day.
They don't have enough cops on the street to stop the murders. But they got the guy fucking mural. He is a real...
I saw somebody painting it black.
Yeah, of course. And she knows it's Friday night. What the fuck?
No time difference. No time. She's in Florida.
Well, I do give you on the panhandle. She's not in the panhandle. But for fuck's sake, I've been doing this for five fucking years, all right? And I swear to God. I can't tell you how many times she's called me during the show.
What, you've seen? It's like I just told you an hour ago.
If she says to you, she'll look at the clock, okay. Where the fuck was it? Eight clocks to that fucking mural. It's pathetic. And I'm telling you right now, Black Lives Matter is losing support.
Yeah, it's never going to go far. So there was another one we had. Was it BLM too, way back in '16?
Yeah, that was the original one.
Mike Brown, Don't Shoot.
Yeah, Hands Up, Don't Shoot.
Look, the police forces do need to be... They need change. I'm all for that. Weeding out the bad cops, ratting out the cops that are bad. Stuff like that. I totally agree with. But defunding?
Are you crazy?
Whenever they cut police forces, crime spikes. That's a fact.
That's why they got so much money.
De Blasio is trying to cause chaos. That's what he wants.
That's what the Democrats want. That's why they're doing it in Seattle.
All the liberal places, Chicago, LA, if you have a party at your house, busted in Chicago. But if you're rioting and looting and burning, you go.
But they won't open up the schools because of the virus, right? San Francisco's got bubonic plague running around in the homeless. And they do nothing.
You know, the bubonic plague is a real thing. I mean, there's cases reported every year.
You know, who has a hot spot?
The bottom of the Grand Canyon.
For some reason, the waste down there seems to be carrying fleas that have bubonic plague.
Must be the only place the fleas live.
Maybe, like the right altitude or whatever. I don't know. But yeah, I've seen that on the National Geographic special.
But the thing is, in the homeless community, because they're all compacted together, and the hygiene is real low, it's just gonna spread. And it's gonna spread outside of the homeless community. And then what? And then who's blaming for it? Trump. Now we got bubonic plague because of Trump. Because people are shitting in the streets and nobody's cleaning it back up. That's why nobody wants to either. When you have an app on your phone that tells you where the shit is on the streets, so you can avoid it, I think there's a problem.
Yeah, Democrats don't want to enforce the law on anything.
Now in San Francisco, if somebody robs you for under $1,000, you can't even report it. So 20 people can go into your store, take $1,000 worth of merchandise.
Because the person only took $1,000.
And the thing is, if they had to live in the fucking community, because they all move out of the district to fucking mansions and shit. And fucking did nothing but scumbag fucking deal with the constituents. And why would they? They've done nothing for them in the last 40 years.
They don't want to hear it.
No, it's not about them. It's about their fucking job. I'm so sick of politicians. Shoot a fucking politician. Do the world a favor.
Absolutely.
I don't know why Pelosi hasn't been shot yet.
I did get to the lawyer's fund. Oh, damn well, I would. I'd fucking pony up for that one.
Shit, yeah.
Yeah, Tomasino. Dude, you heard this motherfucker. And if you don't win,
I'll send another 100 to your canteen.
I wonder if you did kill Nancy Pelosi, how that would go over in jail. Would you be a hero or fucking... Because I'm tending to think that most criminals tend to be liberals.
Yeah, I know. Well, anti-cop.
Well, Nancy Pelosi's a politician. She ain't a cop.
No, she's anti-cop.
Yeah, that's true. And we've gone over this on many other shows. I'm not anti-cop. To the point where you got mad at me. I understand where you're coming from. There's a lot that got to be weeded out, including the ones that come up. Yeah, absolutely. They're just as guilty as he is.
Exactly.
That's why their mother three when he put his knee on the fucking...
They should have grabbed him and pulled him off.
Yep.
Get off him. I watched a video the other day. This fucking guy gets pulled over. The cop comes up to his car like this.
He's like, what the hell are you doing?
He goes, my hands are in plain sight. And the guy says this. He goes, your hands are shaking. Put that gun away. The other cops show up, right? And they're like, well, we suggest you do what he says. He's like, look at him. Look at him. He's in danger. His hands are shaking. He's got a gun on him. He was a private investigator sitting in a parking lot.
Oh, yeah, he was watching somebody, whatever, doing his private investigation.
It's usually ex-cops. It took one cop, I think it was a fairly young black guy, to finally back this cop off him. If that had been me, I would have been scared shitless.
He's got his finger on the trigger, holding it with both hands and shaking.
What the fuck is wrong? How did that guy ever pass that sight exam? It's beyond me. That guy, I guarantee you, I could have got that guy busted. Because they do have to take a sight exam. I could have had him flipping out in two seconds, and then just go unacceptable. Put the big check mark on. Never to be a cop ever, anywhere.
That's right.
They should have to follow them.
Just like teachers that are going on a pedophile shit.
Well, I believe if you're a pedophile, you're not allowed to be a teacher.
You'd be surprised.
But that's one thing Trump put into his police reform bill. That cops couldn't just go from police department to police department without their record following them.
So there was a cop in Woburn, and he shot a guy running away. You fired off the police station.
There was a city next door in Redding. That's ridiculous. That should have never been allowed to happen. And that's when the community should rise up and see.
The kid sued, and he got a shitload of money.
Yeah, but at least he's paid for the care and stuff he needs. I mean, it doesn't replace what happened to him, but what should happen is the people in Redding should have rose up and been down at that police station in the thousands saying, get rid of this guy.
We don't want him here.
Rollins, a little town up here in New Hampshire. Woman calls the cops, says her husband's beating her.
And cops show up.
He's New Orleans, Orleans but Poppy lives in Dover, which is fairly close. And she has three broken ribs. He has a scratch on his face. He identifies himself as a police officer. They took her and charged her with domestic abuse. She had four broken ribs, right?
It was either three or four. I forgot.
He had a little scratch on his face. Look what you did to me! And they arrested her. I'll tell you right now, this one isn't going away.
It's not.
It's all over Facebook. I mean, I know it's a regional thing, but it's not going away. He's 25 years old. He looks like a 14-year-old kid. Fucking, that's what we're hiring. Wasn't he elbowed or something? Elbowed her in the ribs, broke her ribs, or something like that.
I'd have to look at the story again.
It was a little while ago, so I read it.
But they arrested her. Isn't that fucking the DA's wrong with the police department?
Yeah, they should have taken him away.
If there's any place screaming for reform, it's the law enforcement. I agree.
But defunding them is not the answer. That's not. It just makes everyone else unsafe.
I mean, even over in Afghanistan, when they grab the Taliban, they don't grab the shit out of them like the Wuhan cops do.
No, you get in trouble.
You'd have people to answer to.
These people, like I said, nobody to answer to.
My uncle was a Wuhan cop. Chief
pat him on the back saying, good job. My uncle was a Wuhan
cop. Billy McGill?
Yeah, thank you. I only met him a few times, but I liked him. He seemed like a nice guy. I don't know, you've had regular relationships.
He was a good guy. But he was older.
He was drunk and giving him shit.
Oh, okay. The ones, the rookies, they put him on at night.
And they send him out to get the teenagers off the corner, out of the park. All they do is ride around and harass you all night.
See, the town I grew up in, the cars are pretty cool. We used to play frisbee in a supermarket parking lot.
There was a big section that wasn't used. So we'd have frisbee games. Sometimes we'd have like four or five frisbees going. You know, like 10-15 people on each side.
We'd all have our beers, we're all underage.
We all have our beers, but they're hidden. Put your shirt over it or whatever, because you're not wearing a shirt playing frisbee in 90 degree weather.
And they drive through, everything all right, boys. Yep. Just keep going. As long as there was no trouble, they didn't care. We used to have parties out on the trestle. There'd be 200, 300 people there. Big ass bonfire. Cops would pull up, look around, pull out.
Just looking to see if there was any fights going on or something like that.
They didn't care. They knew where we were.
Half the town would be there.
So that's the problem. The cops knew where we were, we'd be hiding behind here or go behind there. No matter where we go, they'd come 15 minutes late.
See, they didn't harass us like that.
They did to us.
We had a pretty cool police force.
I mean, sometimes they take your booze and stuff. Oh, well.
Well, that's what your uncle did. He took the booze from us and said we could go. And we were driving.
Whoa! That was a break.
Like I said, that was back in the 70s.
Well, that's like before all the shit with the drunk driving.
I was up at the Rocks. I was the only person, 21. There was like five people there. And these two girls started fighting. And the cops got called. And there was alcohol. And the cops coming up. And I'm like, hey, I just want to let you know. Fucking, you know. I didn't cure anything. He goes, look. He goes, are you over 21? I go, yeah. He goes, then don't worry. He goes, the alcohol is yours.
Goes way ahead of them.
I was like,
and I cured it. I just had my buddy's truck happened to be under 21.
But that's where they get a lot of their snitches from, the teenagers. They harass when they're kids.
Yeah, because they turn them. I've never been asked.
That's why they let you get away with shit like that. They figure you owe them one or something.
Yeah. I was with this guy. I was with a group of people. I only knew one person. And we pulled behind the Moose Lodge to do some coke, right? Late at night. He goes, I got to take a piss. I'll be right back. So his parents ran the Moose Lodge. They were like the president. And all of a sudden I see lights go on in the Moose, right? This is like 2 o'clock in the morning. So I know it's him.
So I don't know any of these people in the truck. A couple big fucking dudes in a chick, right?
So I went out of there.
So I go, we walk around front and make sure nobody's there.
They're like, oh yeah, go ahead, do that. As soon as I get out of that truck, I grab it.
Right across the golf course, right to home.
So like two days later, I get a call from the cops. They're saying I broke into the Moose Lodge.
I was like, what?
I was like, I didn't fucking break into the fucking Moose Lodge. They go, it was a cool cop. He goes, well, I got to come and talk to you. They knew what had happened. But when they went to ask the person, he said it wasn't him, it was me.
His parents had the keys, right? Keys to the alarm, everything. So they wanted to rat the guy out that said I did it.
I wouldn't do it.
I should have, but I didn't.
So when the cop showed up, he showed up with this other cop that I hated. I said, you said you were coming alone.
He's like, well, he's my superior.
Like, I'm not saying nothing.
So the cops tell me, he's going, look,
we know it wasn't you.
He goes, he ratted you out. All right? He lied and ratted you. And you're not going to tell us what it is. I go, no.
My brother comes out. He walks over. He told me the whole story. It was blah, blah, blah.
They go, that's all we needed. Fucking laugh. You got busted. I haven't been in the Moose Lodge in 10 fucking years.
This happened quite a long time ago.
This is where North Hillview Country Club.
Oh, it is? Yep. Local 1511.
I was a member for a year.
Yeah.
My membership had lapsed. I didn't remember.
I didn't know, right?
So I go walking in. And the fucking guy behind the bar, who I'd known for years, goes, you're not up to date on your membership. You can't drink. I was like, really?
Really?
All right. Never went back. So the guy that was president at that time asked me, why didn't you? Because he sponsored me. He's like, why didn't you use your dudes?
I go, why didn't you? Know?
He goes, what are you going to do now?
I'll never go back there.
What do you mean?
I go,
Fucking,
I don't want to, he's dead.
Elmer.
Elmer fucking told me I can't drink, I'm not up to date on my duties.
Well, it is kind of legal, even though we don't really enforce it right away. We'll give you a warning or two. I go, that's fine. He could have called me up to the bar and told me in private. Instead, he announced it. I go, I will never step in that fucking place again.
And of course I did, but just as a guest, I'd sign it, not get a fucking penny out of me.
But that's how assholes people can be. You could have just said, hey, look, you're not up to date on your dues, that's the rules.
But he announced it.
And the place was fucking crowded as hell.
Just trying to embarrass me.
Dick. Anyways. Forget how the fuck I ended up here.
I don't know. It started out with Brooklyn.
Yeah, the bridge. Well, then we rolled into the police.
Because of the thing about the Moose Lodge, that's how I ended up here. The fucking cops knew it wasn't me.
How the fuck would I have the keys? I guess we're going full strength against fucking China.
Yeah.
Tom says he won't even make an appointment to talk to the guy.
And Hong Kong's lost his special status with us as a trading partner.
I don't know where they're going to go. They're probably coming to the States, because that's the freedom they're looking for.
What, you mean a huge influx from the Hong Kong population?
Well, the businesses. I don't know about the population.
Oh, you mean the businesses?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's going to be a huge...
Where they go?
They're going to go anywhere they can. They'll go to fucking Southeast Asia, anywhere they can. Canada could use some fucking industry.
Yeah.
You know, they don't even build a fucking car. There is no cars that come from Canada. They build cars for us.
Right. For American companies. Canada has no car companies.
They used to make the Brickland. It was a piece of shit.
It kind of looked like a DeLorean.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody bought them. There was tons of shit. They looked pretty cool for the time, but...
But then again, Canada only has a population of 28 million.
I know, we got states with more than that.
Yeah! Oh, California has way more than that.
Well, they got a billion dollar budget like New York does.
Yeah, they have no real armed forces. Not to speak of. And you couldn't drag me to Canada.
Nothing there I want to see.
Nothing.
I went to go see a Stones concert up there in Montreal. Olympic Stadium.
Yeah.
How was it?
You don't remember.
I knew that was coming.
All I know is that it was Froggy Below. This was in December. And there was a fucking, you know, you go into the lobby and do an ATM machine or something?
Yeah. So I had a credit card, so opened the door. We went in there and went to sleep. Halfway during the night, or whatever it was, before the morning, some guy came in and started pissing on the floor. And he went back out.
Oh, fuck, man.
Yeah, that's smart. We have a fucking concert outdoors in Canada at fucking December.
It was closed in the stadium.
Oh, it was closed in the stadium? What do you call it? A huge tent over the building. Was it freezing cold inside?
No.
Okay.
So it was enclosed.
It was enclosed. Okay, that's different.
I thought you meant just like in the fucking outdoors.
Who the fuck is going there? The Rolling Stones is the only concert I ever went sober.
Oh, yeah. I was just going because my girlfriend bought the tickets. I didn't care less about going.
They were all drinking. They're like, you're not going to drink? I was like, nah. I don't feel like it.
I just want to get this over with and go home.
And they did like fucking three encores. I'm like, what the fuck? I want to get out of here.
I probably would have had much more fun. I was a real stick in the mud.
Oh, yeah. I didn't want to go. I told her, take a friend. Really, I'm not a Stones fan. But I can say I've seen the Rolling Stones, and I've seen the Who, and the only reason I went to the Who is because I knew it was going to be a ton of coke and fucking booze.
Back in the '70s, the Stones came to Boston. And the kid that I know, we had a gang fight with Peabody or something.
Peabody? Yeah, I don't know.
Somebody said something to somebody. Next thing you had the whole North Hoon Park was going up to Peabody.
So the next day was the Stones.
Well, the kid I know, he was all beaten up. And he went into the fucking Boston Garden and said, I just got beat up for my ticket. And they let him in.
No shit!
That's 2 nights in a row.
No shit! Smart motherfucker! I like that dude. A buddy, just get on. Paul Oost, sorry, I said his name. Anyways, he used to drive the Zamboni at the fucking guy. And he told me he wants to see, dude. He goes, you don't have a seat, I'll get you in, and you'll have a place to stand and watch the show.
I never took him up on it. I wish I had.
What a fucking life he lives. He fucking works like... Because basketball season and hockey season are basically the same time of year.
Well, yeah, it overlaps. The vast majority of the season overlaps. And hockey starts in November, October, somewhere around there.
Yeah, and goes to April, May. Whatever, yeah. Because he would do the parquet down, he would do that part too, and then run the Zamboni. But he had all summer off. Into the fog. And he beat Montana everywhere.
What, just driving around the country in his fucking Winnebago.
It's like, what a fucking life for Riley. I mean, I was happy for him. Right. Most people would be like, fuck that, I'm happy for the dude. I hate people that hate other people's success.
Oh, yeah.
I love other people's success. I'm not successful.
That's what makes the world go round.
Why are you mad because he's having a great life?
It's like my friend Dana.
He was in the Marines.
He was a Marine mechanic. I think he did like 25 or 30 years.
And when he got out, he had a great pension and shit.
All he did was just drive around the country going around with his Marine buddies.
Constantly. You'd see him on Facebook. Scary. Do you even have a house? Yeah, going to North Carolina, but I'm never there. And then he met a girl. I guess her parents left her. I might be wrong on some of the details of this. But basically, her parents left her farm.
And there was mortgage on it or whatever. And she lost the farm. And it was going up for fucking foreclosure.
He bought the farm back for her. They were together. They're still together. I think they're in Minnesota.
Wrong side of the country to end up on.
But then again, he looks like Grizzly motherfucking ass. Fucking huge bitch and shit. I call him Captain Caveman. But yeah, he fucking ended up...
Meeting this girl and fucking buying her farm, their family farm back. That's a fucking nice person.
But for years, I mean years.
He was just traveling the country.
That's the way to do it.
I wish I had gone into the military and did 30 years.
Yeah, I know. I wish I'd gone in the military. That's a big thing. But like I said, I would be going in the end of Vietnam.
Yeah, I'd be 17.
But no people would be sent at that time. Well, they did come out with the draft had been frozen. Yeah, it was frozen at the end. But then they came out with the new one, and right after that, they de-escalated.
You would have never seen action.
Probably not.
I had a buddy wrecker. He was in the Coast Guard. He was talking about him serving during Vietnam. And I'm just sitting there laughing.
I was like, who the fuck are you kidding? I go, you're in the Coast Guard. You were stationed in Gloucester, all right? You could drive home to your parents' house for dinner at night.
Boy, so during Vietnam?
Yes, you did.
You know, my dad never had his service.
He told her. Yeah, it was in the Korean War. In France.
Joined the Air Force.
He never wanted to see combat. He'd tell you flat out. Fucking, I joined the Air Force to get out of being drafted into the fucking army of Marines.
I had one to join the Air Force, my brother. And he did it because they know they're coming out with the draft.
That's what my dad did because he knew the new draft was coming for Korea. He's a fucked ass.
And he did less time than if he went to Vietnam. I think he had to serve three years. And when you sign up for something, it was only like two years.
Really?
Yeah, it was easier.
My father had to do four years from Korea.
They sent him over to Greenland.
Because he was like a Magneto technician. I don't know.
They told him if he wanted to finish his tour out there,
that they'd take 18 months off his fucking tour.
Send me back to France. He goes, Paul, you've never seen such desolation in your life. I would have said the same thing. Send me back to fucking France.
Yeah, I bet after 2 weeks, Jim, you'd be going, Well, I climbed the walls here when I started living alone, and I got used to it.
I'll tell you what, with the old lady down in Florida, I've got to admit, it's very peaceful at home.
Not that she's disruptive or anything.
But I, I, I,
I'll be glad when she gets home. But
you're enjoying it.
Yes, I am.
Seattle.
Yes, Seattle blows. So what?
The man.
What's her face?
Got your name right?
She's the man in Seattle.
They've got a recall on her.
Is that when they had the Chop City?
Yes.
And then that's Mayor Durkin.
Okay. Liberals and conservatives have joined forces to oust her.
With petition.
They need, I think, I forget the number. 24,000 signatures.
Guy said, we'll get that. No problem.
And I believe a city councilwoman too is up on that.
She only needs like 15,000 to go up for recall. We'll double that. I believe at least three mayors nationwide have petitions for recalls.
And surprisingly, all liberals.
So in all the cities.
I can't find an example of one Republican. I think they should no interference from Trump at all.
Let him live that way. They want to keep voting assholes like that in. Let them live with it.
I agree.
Let them live in their misery.
They created it.
But it's not fair to the people that are invested in this area. Because housing prices are staggering. And these people invested... Now the property value is shit. Because of all these fucking assholes. They're trapped. I feel bad for them people.
The business is going to leave. Big time out of the Democratic states.
Some major glass company. I forget the name. Northwest Glass. They've been in business only 45 years. They did the glass work for the... No, for the Amazon headquarters in Seattle. Two big glass balls. Up front?
Oh, yeah, they did the glass work for that, right?
No, the company bought them. Bye-bye, we live in Seattle. But their Arizona shop, nobody being affected.
No, they bought both places.
They bought the two places in Arizona, one in Seattle.
The one in Seattle? Goodbye. They're gone. They don't want that shit, why would they?
I said, there's a lot of people thinking of coming up with opening up businesses, small businesses. Now they look at where they're at.
Exactly, location.
And they stayed away from the liberal states. Liberal states don't have the citizens in mind like Trump does. They don't have our back.
And you've seen even union people
are starting to walk away from the Democrats.
I mean, when they made the announcement that Amazon was going to basically ran Amazon out of New York.
Right, Ocasio did.
Did you see the look on their New York faces?
No, like I said, that's their constituents.
And they're like, that would have kept us working for another three years. And how many jobs was it we were going to bring?
75,000.
Was it 25?
It was a staggering number for one area.
And it fucking occupied because the Ocasio-Cortez decided it wasn't right. Well, how about the people that fucking live there? You fucking whore. I hate her. I hope they redistrict her out.
Oh, I hope so, because they can't get enough to turn Amazon away. You know what I mean? They got nothing for her. She could have sucked and brought that in. She would have got a second term.
Yeah, would have been a guarantee. And she was like, these aren't high-paying jobs. They were high-paying jobs.
Yeah, the ones in the stock room ain't high-paying jobs.
Yeah, but I think at the lowest it was like $20 an hour.
What does she want? $500 an hour?
She's an ass.
How about you ask the people how they feel about it?
Exactly. She just turned it away without asking.
Because she enjoys making other people's lives miserable. That's what Democrats do. They live in chaos.
Which in turn is making her life miserable.
It works out. But the real funny part is, Jim, She wins no matter what, because she gets paid for the rest of her life, health insurance. Right. And she can still get $174,000 a year. I don't think it's that much. I guarantee it's $100,000. Not the pension. The pension's usually smaller. That's something worth. Anyways, even if it's $50,000. She collects it for the rest of her life. And your health insurance is paid for the rest of her life. Who else gets a job where you can work for fucking years?
Joe Biden.
She's only into two. Ocasio-Cortez is only into two. She's a representative. She's not a senator. Senator is 6 years. Representatives are 2 years.
I thought it was four.
No, it's every 2 years.
Really?
Governors and presidents.
Oh! I didn't know that, Jim.
The terms.
I didn't know that. So all this bullshit I heard has been in 2 years.
Since 18.
It seems like it's been forever.
Oh, I know. Well, it's been over a year. Because she didn't get in until January of 19.
She is as dumb as a fucking stump.
You can see why she was a bartender.
Oh, yeah.
She ain't got many skills for anything else.
I'd love to see her gone.
This is the media propping her up. The liberal media.
Even the Muslim community.
I hear.
Minneapolis? Is that where Ilhan Omar's from?
Yeah.
They're running people against her. The Muslim community is. They're sick of her. And I would love to see her back in her office, get the fuck out of here. And then when she's out, you can slap the cuffs on her. And charge her with immigration fraud. I forget how much money she sent to her husband's fucking consulting company from the campaign.
$195,000.
Something like that. That sounds perfectly legal to me.
She's in the money.
She got her fucking flamboyant brother over here by marrying him. And that's a fact. It's not even open for dispute.
Why ain't they doing anything about it? They knew it when Obama was in office.
Didn't she come in the same time as that?
No, it came out. No, 2018, Obama was in.
Yeah, I was going to say, she came in the same time as Cortez.
Right, 18.
And Presley, she's another winner from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. That shows you just how dumb they are. That's why I left Massachusetts, because they look like idiots.
Then I come up here, and they all moved up here, the Democrats and liberals.
But what about that New Hampshire flip this time?
I think so.
Hillary just barely won, and I mean, by like a couple thousand votes, if that.
Yeah, it wasn't much.
So I'm pretty sure that this is going to New Hampshire.
They didn't say anything about having a rally tomorrow night, right?
I haven't heard anything.
I've been watching the news, so I stay away from the news. I can't watch it anymore. I can't even watch local news. It's pathetic. It's so fucking one-sided.
Yeah, I don't watch local news. Do you know what I want to know? I want to know the weather. I go to my phone. I don't need to have some person pointing to a fucking high or low or whatever.
So the meteorologist out of a job.
Yeah, I don't fucking need him. I don't want him. I'm sick of local TV. I got internet TV on my smart TV. It's got all these fucked up channels. And that's what I watch 90% of the time.
I can pick what I want.
Right. And it's all what I watch, like the documentary channels and stuff like that. I just avoid the news. It's so slanted.
If I go on Facebook and something looks interesting, like a news story, I'll pop it open. But other than that...
I'm so sick of hearing peaceful protesters.
Did you hear about Ruth Bader Ginsburg? She went in the hospital for an infection.
I don't know what it was, but they let her go a couple days.
Said she's doing well. Then today or yesterday, they put her in for cancer. She's having bi-weekly chemotherapies.
She's on her way out.
Oh, God, yeah. And the good thing is, right? The election's coming soon. So they can't say, well, Trump can't pick the next person because when Trump wins, another one. Trump gets another one. And watch the fucking media call this person literally Satan. Because they've tried all the other shit. They're going to say, oh, he raped a woman, blah, blah.
Remember that? What was her name there? Ford?
What was her name? Oh, that was Kavanaugh.
Yeah, they dragged this fucking woman out of nowhere.
She volunteered. She was a flake.
And as long as we hold the Senate, we're good.
She couldn't work with her. Like I said, if they had a better record, they could have probably got away with it. But she was just trying to look 14. She's in her 50s.
Yeah, fucking retarded. Put her in a Catholic school uniform.
Basically what they did.
See a couple movies like that.
You know what I mean? Oh, porn?
Yeah, they got a 35-year-old woman, and she's got, like, pigtails, and fucking schoolgirl outfits, You could have at least found an 18-year-old.
Exactly.
I was like, my wife was watching Fast and Furious. It was in Tokyo. I forget what it's called. And the lead character, the guy that died, Paul Walker. He's in high school, right? And it's all Asian kids, right? And I look and I go, he's in high school.
Yeah, I go,
when the fuck did 35-year-old men go to high school? I go, how unbelievable is this? I mean, I don't mind suspending reality to get something done for a movie, watch it move on. But that takes you right the fuck out of the movie. He could have been half the kid's fathers.
Jesus. And he must tower over the Japanese.
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know, because I only watched about 30 seconds. He's like six, seven. But I just took the time to point that back. You think I'm watching that? Goes off a jump, rolls three times in the air, lands perfectly. No undercarriage damage. Like I call the fake and the frivolous. what a bunch of dumb fucking movies. And they made like nine or ten of them. The fuck watches? Well, never mind. I know who watches kids.
Teenagers.
And my wife always hits me like, well, you watch Star Wars. Yeah.
But they're not supposed to be based in reality.
You get it? One's about the future, right? So pretty much anything goes, it's the future, you can make it up. And one's a fucking space cartoon for kids, Star Wars. You're not supposed to believe Darth Vader is real.
I do love them. Except for the Disney ones, they suck.
Do they?
Yeah. Well, you watched one, you were smashed. But it was horrible. The only good Star Wars made by Disney was Rogue One. Rogue One was a pretty good movie, I have to admit.
And The Mandalorian.
The series on Disney Plus. It's a good show. It really is. It's basically one of Dead or Alive in space. You know, because Steve McQueen was the bounty hunter, but he had a heart, you know what I mean?
Same with The Mandalorian. He's like this race of warriors and stuff, and he's a bounty hunter, but when it comes down to it,
he's a good guy with principles. The only thing is, when did this start? You have a series. They make 13 of them. And then they're off. And you gotta wait like eight months for the next season to come out. It's like, what the fuck?
They can do more seasons than that quicker, that's for sure.
How about just doing like 26 episodes for a season?
If they're gonna, that's true. That's half a year.
Exactly.
Same with sports.
You can film 26 episodes in a year.
Yeah, they only take a couple of months to do, and then they get the rest of the time off.
What you do is you write the scripts way ahead. You got your scripts fucking years ahead. And you're filming a year ahead. I mean, how fucking hard is that?
Get them while you can.
But they're all doing it. All the streaming services. They put out these series, and there's only 13 fucking episodes. Picard, which I've never watched. I don't know how many, but I think it was only like 13 episodes. That other shit show that CBS put out, Discovery. I think that's another 13 episode season.
Discovery?
Yeah, Star Trek Discovery.
Oh, I thought you meant Discovery.
No. I haven't seen either of them, so I can't judge them. But every critic I've listened to, I'm not paying for CBS All Access. Not doing it. They all say they both suck. And I gotta put my faith in, if there's that many critics saying how bad it is, it's gotta be pretty bad.
Right.
So I'm not gonna waste my money on it. Why would I? I got Disney Plus.
Well, the wife got it.
But you get You got Disney, ESPN, I forget which else.
There's three channels you get for this when you get Disney Plus.
But ESPN, I can get Monday Night Football. Am I going to watch it this year? Ten doubt it. If they're going to be fucking, everyone's going to be kneeling, and they're going to be playing the Black National Anthem, and all that crap, right?
I'm not watching, I'm not partaking.
You're producing a product I find to be inferior.
They're making football political.
Yep, that's all Bedell. Yeah, he really is a dick.
He threw fucking football and has been.
I feel that there's a lot of people that aren't going to be watching football this year.
Kind of get used to it. I'll find something else to do. You know what I mean? Fuck it. I don't have to watch it.
I'll still be able to see the scores.
That's the two-minute warning.
No, it's not. Oh, 5 minute warning. 12. 4 something.
Okay.
Yeah, it's 4 now. You gonna make a drink? You got any last topics you want to do?
Trying to think of something.
Did we talk about almost this shit?
No.
Trump tweeted a picture of himself at the desk of the Oval Office.
I forget the name of the desk.
Whatever. With some FOIA products in front of him. And he's got the thumbs up. Chris Cuomo had a fucking mental breakdown on the air.
You know, we don't have time for this bullshit.
When did saying bullshit on a cable news network become acceptable?
When it's Chris Cuomo.
We don't have time for this bullshit. Corona this, Corona that.
Why won't you say that?
People
burning and looting.
He's such a pathetic fraud.
He's a real piece of shit. I don't watch him. I don't watch CNN, period.
Oh, no, I see the story popped on my feed. It's the only reason I checked it out. I don't watch CNN. Are you fucking crazy?
Their ratings are worse than fucking Nick at Night.
They are, literally. Tucker's getting better ratings. Than all three other channels combined.
Good.
Yep. MSNBC, CNN, and
MSNBC, ABC, CBS.
Yeah, what up?
But anyway, he's getting better ratings. And they tried going after the sponsors.
Some sponsors pulled out of Tucker's show.
Yeah. Then the ratings started to go through the roof. And guess what the sponsors wanted back? They wanted back, and I said, go fuck yourself.
But of course, they're a business.
They got to take the sponsors. All right, we got about a minute and a half. You want to say goodbye to the troops and shit?
Yeah. Shout out to the troops serving abroad, here at home.
Be safe. Come home safe. Hopefully Trump's going to get all the troops out of Afghanistan real soon.
He's working on it.
So that'll be a good thing. You'll be able to come back home, see your families.
You deserve that.
And you guys have been stellar. We appreciate everything you do.
I'd like to give a shout out to law enforcement.
To all the law enforcement people out there that are doing their job and doing it properly.
And getting screwed for it.
Remember that.
The Brooklyn Bridge.
Yeah. Remember that when you go to vote, guys.
The union isn't your boss.
We are. Vote red. Vote Trump. Anything you want to talk about, Jim?
We got another minute. Oh, 40 seconds.
And then 20 of that is the song. Who's up next?
Don Wisman with the All Aboard. And then we have Casey Spears with Betrayal at 10 o'clock.
That was a new show?
No, she's been around for a while.
No, it's a new show.
Yeah, it's a brand new show.
The Fall of El Chapo.
Ooh, that sounds interesting.
It's huge, has some interest in it.
Yeah, I'd like to see it go.
I'm so glad that piece of shit is behind bars.
But Deshaun Penn is too.
You get a reprieve.
Yeah. All right, so let's say goodnight. All right, buddy, good night.
Same time, same channel.
The 22-year-old virgin is in the house.
That wasn't a bad show.
No. We had nothing.
I was angry. I was fun. I was charmed. I was low. Tell me how I chime now.